Here's an update on version 2 of my fat e-bike. I built the original one on a cheap Mongoose Hitch bike frame, fat bike, just to test out and see if I really liked riding a fat bike with a motor, and it was really fun. But the Mongoose bike was not fun. There it is over there. It's been tore down, and all the e-bike stuff has been taken off, and it will get reassembled and put back together as a regular pedaling bike, and then I'll sell it. It's only a month old. Somebody will like to have that bike, but it's, you know, really an expensive bike. You can't expect much out of it. Everything was steel. It was 45 pounds out of the box, new. So anyways, it served well as a test unit. But then, after I rode it, I guess a couple weeks, I ordered complete carbon fiber frame, fork, and wheel set, and transferred the whole e-bike motor kit and some of the parts over to this bike here you're looking at now. I'm going to go over this bike now. This freaking came out awesome. I'm going to tell you, this puts that cheap red bike over there to shame. Of course it should, and it does. But let's start at the front here. Carbon fiber 4-inch rims front and back. Panaracer Fat Be Nimble 26x4 tires, 120 threads per inch. Super supple. I couldn't believe the first ride I did last night after putting this together. This bike rode so awesome with those really soft, flexible tires compared to the wire bead, super hard tires on that Mongoose over there. But like I said before, it's a cheap bike, and that's what you get with a cheap bike. So, full carbon fiber fork, 150 millimeter front axle. Carbon fiber wheel, like I said. When we go to the frame, it's a 18 inch full carbon fiber fat frame with 197 millimeter rear axle. And I got a Shimano cassette hub because in order to get the chain line correct, you need to pull some of the gears farthest in out and move everything over, because the chain line ends up being too much like that. This, I already had a 9-speed SRAM derailleur in a drawer, paid for many years ago. I was never going to use it again. So I ordered a SRAM XO 9-speed shifter, and I had a 9-speed Shimano chain already in a drawer, paid for. So I'll get back to the drivetrain there, but that's why I didn't go for a SRAM XD. You can't take the cassettes apart. With some of the cheaper Shimano cassettes, you unscrew a screw in the back, or sometimes there's three, and every piece of the cassette comes apart, and you can stack the gears how you want. So right now, instead of a 9-speed, I've got it set up as 7-speed, and I'll go over that, like I said, in a minute here. Let's keep going here. Let's go up to the dash. Carbon fiber bars I had from a previous build several years ago I didn't like on the particular bike I used them on. That's the SRAM XO 9-speed shifter. These grips are just on temporarily. I had them in a drawer. They're real soft, but they mildewed sitting in a drawer all these years. They're foamy. I've got the Ergon grips coming that have the nice palm rest. They're real soft. There's the Luna 750C display for the e-bike motor. Let me go back to the brakes here a minute. Shimano MT200, I think these models are. $70 on Amazon. work awesome. I have XT brakes on those two carbon bikes you see hanging over there, but I didn't want to put the money that XT brakes cost into this bike here. So fortunately, these brakes actually worked out really well. They have a longer lever, and this bike is heavy, so you go back to two-fingered braking compared to one-fingered braking on XT with the real short levers. But two-fingered braking on these brakes feels just fine. I like it. It's been many years since I did two-finger braking. So that's the front end. A 1.25 to 1.5 inch headset. And over here we have the assist plus and minus for the e-bike system. And that's a throttle. I hardly ever use that. It's pretty dangerous. It's got so much power, I don't want to snap a chain, so I stay off of that. I might even take it off in the future, but for right now, it's on the bike. And there is the Luna Wolf 52 volt battery, 13.5 amp hour. And down here is the big Luna BBSHD motor. It's been tuned a little hotter by Luna themselves. Stock crank arms that come with the BBSD kit, but I use clip-in pedals. These are Speed Play Frogs. I have three sets of them there, so that's on there. Did real nice wire routing here, kept it real clean, no wrapping around stuff. Let's get down to the brakes here for a minute before I get too much further here. I found on the big red Mongoose bike that these 203 millimeter rotors made a huge difference in stopping power. I had these rotors left over from a Yeti ASX bike I had about 2003, I think it was. And I pieced out the bike when I sold it. So the rotors were in a drawer. I already owned them. So all I had to do was buy some 203 millimeter adapters here. And huge stopping power with the 203s. If you've got 160s or 180s and you've got a really heavy e-bike, go to 203s, man. You won't regret it. Unbelievable. By the way, I'm not going tubeless on these, even though I can. I've put tubes in them because where I ride this bike is way back in without cell phone reception in the Pisgah National Forest on gravel roads and stuff. And I would just hate like hell to burp this tire with 6 pounds in it and then not be able to get it to inflate again for tubeless. So weight is really not a huge issue with the BBSHD. So I've got inner tubes in these wheels here. And that's just fine with me. I mean, I go tubeless stands on all my other bikes, but so let's keep going here. Let's go to the back here. Here's the 203 millimeter rotor back here and the 203 adapter that sets the caliper up higher. And this frame was really cool because, let me go around the other side here. I did not know this, but it comes with threaded inserts here and here, so apparently it's rack ready. And I'll have to go hunt up what kind of rack would fit on here. These chain stays and the front fork are so wide, 5-inch tires can fit on this frame easily. Look at that space. That's awesome. I already had this race face seat post. A bunch of this info was already on the previous videos of the Mongoose, but I already owned that seat post, and I had to get a 27.2 to 31.6 adapter to be able to use it on this frame. I already had this quick release in a drawer, so I didn't have to buy that. I already had this Yeti saddle from an old Yeti build. Let's see here. Let's get down. Let's talk about the drivetrain now. I had this brand new SRAM S7 9-speed derailleur in a drawer. Didn't have to buy that. I don't know why I had it, but it had never been used. It's brand new. I had this 9-speed SRAM cassette in a drawer, and like I said, this all came completely apart. Let me get around here and show you. We can see out back here. Sorry for the wiggling here. Might be hard to see, but let me go on this side. There's two gears back behind this big 34 here and the spacers. And I've got this set up as a 7-speed now to get my chain line right. So that chain line looks pretty good right there. You get up on the 34, it's a little bit this way. It's not horrible, but when it was a 9-speed, way over here on the 34, it was just cranked way over. And you don't need that many gears for an e-bike. I mean, I could probably go down to 6 or 5. So all you would do is move one more of these on the back, and the big 34 would come over here in this space. And then I had a different chain ring on the Mongoose because these chain stays were not jutted out so far. I had a 42, this is it right here. And I really like this chain ring, but look at the offset. It's almost an inch. So I get together, start putting together this, and I stick it on here, and the teeth hit the frame, and they send you spacers to bring it out this way further, but you would have to bring it out so far that this chain ring and this center steel round area, this would not even be sitting on the round area anymore, which is not good. So anyways, I went back to this Luna 30 tooth chain ring that I had, that I bought with the motor kit, because I wasn't sure what kind of gearing I would need. And I'm going to use that for now. I really need an offset that's about right here in the middle line of the motor case. The chain ring up on the bench I showed you is way over here, which, like I said, it worked great for the red bike frame over there. It didn't have chain stays that stuck out that far. But on this bike, I got to come back about 10 millimeter this way. So anyways, I'm going to use this chain ring for now, and we'll see how it goes. Oh, let's see. Did I get everything? I took the first test ride on this last night in the dark, and this thing handles so much better and rides so much better than that old steel cheapy monster over there. These tires, I bought these because they're 58 bucks on Amazon, these Fat B Nimbles, and I wanted something with a pretty good height knob, and I didn't want $100 a piece tires. We'll see how much mileage we get out of this here. I mean, there are 4-inch wide tires out there that have much bigger and thicker knobs on them, but for now, I'm going to go with these. They're not really super wide this way, but this will work great for the kind of riding I do on this bike. This is not a single track trail bike. I do mostly forest, gravel roads, grassy roads, and stuff like that on this bike. If I go on single track and stuff, I take one of the mountain bikes over here. So this bike has a special purpose, and I'm really glad that I put it together, because this thing is just, I'm loving it. I got the frame, the fork, and the wheel set from a merchant on AliExpress. $425 for the frame and the fork and free shipping. $630 for the wheel set with the Shimano hub, free shipping. So $425 and $630. Unbelievable. Previously, I've put these two carbon bikes together over here and bought the wheel sets carbon and the frames carbon and had to pay shipping, like $100 shipping or something crazy like that. So I just kind of really lucked into this deal from this particular merchant, who only had a couple fat bike items. He wasn't a big store where he had a bunch of road bike frames and mountain bike frames. So worked out good. And look at the spacing on this front fork here. You can run a 5.0 tire on that dog there, man. Unbelievable. But that's the update on the new Carbon Fat bike. I haven't taken it out on a long ride yet. I did some more stuff today, like putting the 203 millimeter rotors on and installing the proper headset and all that. So it's ready now to be taken out and put through the paces. But right now it's clean and it's the best it's ever going to look, because once you take a new bike out, you get stone chips and all kinds of stuff on it. So take a good look. That's how good it looks right now. And I'm really happy with this build so far. And that's the update for now.